Hello everyone, it's Melon from Soapncrafts, and I'm delighted to welcome you back to my channel. 3 years ago, I uploaded a video titled Make Crystal Clear Soap in Less Than 10 Minutes. That video garnered over 19 million views and received 5,000 likes. However, it also generated numerous questions about the method used. As a result, I've decided to revisit the topic and provide a more detailed, step-by-step guide with thorough explanations. Additionally, I'll address some frequently asked questions towards the end of this video. My aim is to ensure that you have a comprehensive understanding of this method. The primary goal of creating ultra-clear transparent soap is to push the boundaries of transparency to its highest possible level. In this video, our focus is not on teaching you how to make soap base from scratch. Additionally, we won't be addressing concerns such as alcohol smell, sweat, foaming, or soap hardness. If you're interested in learning how to make transparent soap base, you can find a detailed tutorial on my website. Simply click the link in the top right corner. Furthermore, if you purchase the tutorial, assistance is available in our Facebook group.
Preparation, essential tools and equipment.
The essential tools and equipment we need are as follows: a stove top to heat up the ingredients, gloves to protect your hands from touching the lye, goggles to shield your eyes in case of splashes, and a mask, which is crucial for this process. A scale to weigh the ingredients, a large metal mixing bowl that can be used directly on the stove top. Whisk to quickly mix the ingredients and ensure they are completely dissolved. Two mixing cups, one for the lye water and the other for alcohol. The container and molds to store or shape the final product. And last but not least, a thermometer. It's important to note that the success tip for this process lies in monitoring and controlling the temperature.
Preparation ingredients.
In making this crystal transparent soap, there are six essential ingredients required. The first ingredient is coconut oil. I recommend using fractionated coconut oil instead of solid coconut oil, as it tends to yield a higher level of transparency in the soap. However, if you prefer to use solid coconut oil, opting for virgin organic would also result in a good outcome. Please refer to the description for the appropriate amount of lye needed for each type of coconut oil. Stearic acid serves the dual purpose of preventing the soap from becoming too soft and reacting with lye during the soap making process. Glycerin plays a pivotal role in this recipe, serving as the key ingredient for achieving transparency in the soap. Additionally, it contributes hydration property for the product. Like crystals, also known as sodium hydroxide, are an essential component of this recipe. It's imperative to use 100% pure sodium hydroxide. Additionally, distilled water, not tap water, should be used to dilute the lye crystals. The final ingredient is alcohol, which serves multiple purposes in this recipe. It acts as a solvent to dissolve all the ingredients, aids in achieving transparency, and also accelerates the saponification process. Any type of alcohol can be used for this recipe. Preferably, 99% alcohol is preferred, but 70% alcohol will also suffice.
Process, weigh, and heat up the ingredients. Process, weigh, and heat up the ingredients.
We will prepare phase A in the metal bowl by weighing out 140 grams of fractionated coconut oil, 60 grams of stearic acid, and 400 grams of glycerin. Set the metal bowl on the stove and turn on the heat. Heat it up until it reaches a temperature above 95 C. As the temperature approaches the desired level, reduce the heat. Meanwhile, prepare the lye water. When starting the soap making process, it's crucial to remember the standard practice of never pouring water into the lye crystals, but rather the other way around. However, this time, I'm going to break that rule, because we want the lye water to reach a higher temperature. We will prepare phase B in a mixing cup by weighing out 41 grams of sodium hydroxide and 82 grams of distill or pure water. For phase C, we need to weigh 300 grams of alcohol, which can be any type ranging from 70 to 99%.
Process mixing all the ingredients. Process mixing all the ingredients.
Both phase A and B have reached the desired temperature, and they are even higher than expected. This means that when we mix them, you'll observe a soap volcano effect, much like boiling lava. This reaction is precisely what we aimed for, but we must proceed with extreme caution. Begin by mixing phase B with phase A, pouring the lye water into the oil combination. It's crucial not to pour everything at once. Instead, do so gradually and with caution. With each addition, you'll observe the soap is bubbling. Pause to mix until it cools down. Then proceed to pour more. Mix thoroughly until the mixture turns clear again before moving on to the next step. Next, pour phase C, the alcohol, into the AB mixture. Once again, you'll witness the bubbling, so pour the alcohol gradually, slow down and stir as you observe the rise. Continue this process until everything is thoroughly mixed. Thorough mixing is essential to ensure that no oil remains floating on top of the mixture. If you observe any oil still floating, continue mixing until the solution turns clear. Now that the solution is clear, we need to wait for the temperature to drop down before pouring it into the mold. I prefer to wait until the temperature drops below 60 degrees Celsius. If you need to add fragrance or essential oils, you could add it before pouring into the mold. The recommended amount of scent is around 1 to 2% of the soap total. Please wrap your soap to prevent sweating. This recipe contains a high amount of glycerin, so it's not recommended to try it if you live in a humid climate or during times of very humid weather. In the next video, I'll demonstrate a foaming test and include a FAQ section to address the most frequently asked questions. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider supporting me by subscribing or visiting my website to purchase my tutorial class. Your support means a lot. See you in my next video.